And because I am curious about this matter, I began to give thought to this night factor in religion. I had not thought of it before, but the story of the Bible hangs on the hinges of some strange and unusual occurrences which took place in the night. That leads me to suggest that maybe God does some of his best teaching through encounters in the night. I read again the 19th Psalms, and there I read David declaring that the heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament shows his handiwork. Day unto day uttereth speech, and night unto night showeth knowledge. Maybe, just maybe, there is some knowledge to be gained in the night that I can't learn in the sunlight. Maybe there are some lessons God has to teach me at midnight hour that you can absorb in the brilliancy of the noonday sun. The Bible says Jacob wrestled with an angel in the night. God sent the death angel to Egypt in the night. Israel was led through the wilderness with a cloud by day and a pillar of fire in the night. Belshazzar saw a finger writing on the palace wall in the night. Jesus was born with the angels singing glory to God in the highest. They were singing it in the night. The disciples went fishing and caught nothing in the night. Nicodemus came to hold a conference with Jesus to interview Jesus in the night. Jesus spoke to the waves and told them, "Peace, be still," in the night. There was a prayer meeting in Philippi when Paul started to pray and Silas started to sing and the jailhouse started to rock in the night. Judas went out of a cold, old upper room to betray Jesus, and the gospel says that Judas went out in the night. Jesus prayed in the Garden of Gethsemane, "Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me." He prayed it in the night. Jesus hung on the cross on Friday, and even though the clock time said 3:00 in the afternoon, the eternity realized that no, it's not 3:00 in the afternoon, but that it was so dark that it looked like midnight. Yes. Tell me that the sun refused to shine. And when the sun don't shine, it's nighttime. Yes. Question again is how long the night? The standard mode of understanding this night predicament is to look to the testimony of others. No matter how hard it is with you, no matter how dismal your days or how miserable your nights, somebody else has been where you are going. That's why we look to hear other testimonies about what the Lord has done for them. We like to hear David say, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadows of the Almighty. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day." We love to hear Jeremiah say, "His compassion fails not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness." We don't mind joining with Job, who looked forward, and I believe he could see it, to when the morning stars would sing together and the sons and daughters of God would shout for joy. It makes us feel good when we read over and over, "Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning." I don't know how long your night was or how long your night is, but I do want to know how long my night will be. I'm not so sure that the testimony of others is sufficient It sounds sometimes strange for me as a pastor to say, but I want to know how long my night is. I know there's better days that are going to come, but how long is my night? I know one day, every day will be Sabbath, and every month will be like the month of May. I got sunshine on a cloud today. How long is my night? I know God moves in mysterious ways and His wonders to perform, but how long is the night? I know I need to wait on the Lord and be of good courage, but how long is my night? I know Jesus is near to comfort and to cheer just when I need Him the most, but how long is my night? I know that earth has no sorrow, that heaven cannot heal, but how long is my night? I know He knows just how much we can bear. But how long is my night? I know there's a bright side somewhere. I'm climbing up the rough side of the mountain. But thank God, I want to believe that God is at the top. I still want to know how long the night. I'm learning that the longer my night is, the less time I have to wait. You can't run through the night. You can't skip over the night. You can't avoid the night. You got to endure the night. The word says, he that endureth to the end shall be saved. If you want to know how long the night, the question is, it's not long. The same God who closes the curtain of the night also opens the curtain for the morning. How long? Not long. He promised to wipe away every tear from every eye, from my eye. How long? Not long. He will be soon one morning when this life is over. God will show up. How long? Not long. He promised a city with a tree of life for the healing of the nation. There'll be no more sorrow, no more sadness. Come on, no more sickness, no more dying, no more killing, no more lies, no more backstabbing, no more putting somebody else against somebody else. No more standing on one side. No. I'm for this elder. No, I'm for that elder. No, I believe in this elder. No. I'm no longer keep concerning about the night.
What I gotta understand is that this godly sorrow that I have to lead me to repentance. That's where we need to go. It's yes. Thank God for what my wife shared with me. Yes. We sorry, but most of the time we worldly sorry. We sorry because we got to confess that we're sorry. That we made a mistake. But we don't fully understand and comprehend that we got to have a godly sorrow. God is watching. Oh, wait a minute. Let me see. I remember her saying, can you hide anywhere from God? By the way, I was looking for one of those little coloring things, too. I want to see what's in that blank. I think I could outcolor those kids. But what I'm trying to tell you now is that we don't. Sin can blind you. Sin can fool you. Sin can make you think you're getting over. And you don't even understand that God is still up there. Godless sorrow. You simply got upset that you got caught. Been there. Know what it is to realize as David. I ain't sinned against you.
Should be. We enjoy. We glorify God. I ain't coming in here with no more. wonderful He is. What a blessing He is. How dare I not be a blessing to somebody else? Let's call a relationship with God. We're living in the night. That's why we got to come together so we can help each other, uplift each other. Stiff neck. Don't want to interact with the other people. Excuse me. But God put us here for a purpose. To understand, night is here, but joy comes. And it's in the morning. And guess what? My morning is right there. That's my morning. That's my morning. Whenever I look at her now, I look at her, thank you, God. Thank you. because I'm still stuck in my mess. I'm still in my night. I still not letting go of sin. Sometimes we lie to ourselves so much that we don't even realize that we lie to ourselves. Fully do not even comprehend that what we are doing is contrary to what thus saith the Lord. But oh my goodness, when you find out, when you come to the realization, if you don't let go of it, it will kill you. It will destroy you. It will take all that you have and then some for God to be so gracious to try to help you heal and mend the hearts that you already broken and destroyed. You got to beg God's forgiveness in every individual.